Tina. I'm Sam. I'm going to be your therapist today.
How are you?
Today I'm going to be taking you through a series of stretches and exercises. It's very important that before we do any of this, you warm up before the exercise. You can do 5 minutes of a light jog, running outside, and then cool down after the exercise using something like some cold towels or an ice pack as well, just to help prevent some muscle injury. The first thing that we're going to be doing is a static stretch. A static stretch is essentially taking two attachment points of a muscle and moving them further away from each other and holding that without any movement. The muscle that we're going to be stretching is your right middle scalenes. These muscles are a group that run from here to here, and they're responsible for bringing your neck to one side. The reason that we're doing this is because you came in testing short, so we want to lengthen the muscle and give you some more range of motion through the neck. The potential risk could be that you could overstretch and cause some tearing, so just work within the parameters that I give you. Do you have any questions so far?
No.
Okay, so I'm going to demonstrate. I'm just going to set up here. So what I'm going to have you do, you can stay seated, and we're going to be working on the right side. So you're going to take your left hand, and you're going to slowly move your neck the opposite way until you feel that first barrier, which is like a first sense of stretch or a pull. And then you're going to hold that for 30 seconds. It's really important that you don't have any bouncy or ballistic movements. So we're just going to be going into a nice, smooth, passive stretch. Once you've held for 30 seconds, you can then go into your second barrier, which would just be your next sense of stretch, and then do that again for your third barrier, for your third sense of stretch. If there's any pain at any time, please let me know. We will stop or we'll modify. Do you have any questions?
No.
Okay, so I'd like to see you do it, please. And are you feeling that first sense of stretch?
Yes.
Okay, can you just point to where that is? Great, just make sure that you're comfortable throughout the movement.
Yeah.
And make sure that you're breathing properly through it. Okay, great. And sorry, so I should mention this. 1, 2, 3, and then I'll say, make sure that you're comfortable, make sure that you're breathing. 27, 28, 29, 30. We're counting that 30. So make sure that you repeat this at home, and you will do this, and then you'll go through two more barriers. So you'll go through three barriers, and you can do this daily until you see me next. Do you have any questions?
No.
Perfect. Okay, the second thing that we're going to be doing is an isometric strengthening exercise to your left quadricep. So an isometric exercise is essentially contraction of the muscle with no movement at the joint. The quadricep group is a group of muscles that run from here to here and essentially responsible for straightening your leg. The reason that we're going to be doing this is because you've tested weak, so we do want to strengthen that muscle just to help with some stability around the knee. A risk could be that you could overwork the muscle and then you could tear it. So just work within the parameters that I give you, okay? Any questions so far?
No.
Okay, if you have pain at any time, please let me know. We'll stop and we'll modify the exercise, okay? So I will demonstrate for you first. It's a multi-angle joint exercise, meaning that we're going to go through three different joints. So I will show you what we'll be doing, and then I'll have you perform. Okay, so if I can just sit up here. So what I'm going to have you do is, the first joint is going to be held for 5 reps. Each rep is going to be 5 seconds each, and then we're going to move through 2 other joints. So what I'm going to do is actually my left quad, so I'm going to take my right leg and I'm going to place it right over my left. And what I'm doing is just pushing into the other leg. And I'm going to do this for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Relax. That was 1 rep. We're going to do 5 of those. Then I'm going to move to my next joint angle and then my next joint angle. Okay? I'm going to do this, so I'm going to have you do this at 50% of your strength and those 3 sets. Okay?
Okay.
Any questions?
No.
I'm not sure if I mentioned, but if you have pain at any time, let me know. We'll stop and modify.
Okay.
And we'll hold that for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Relax. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5. Relax. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5. Relax. Make sure that you're breathing properly.
Yeah.
Are you comfortable?
Yes.
Do you feel the contraction?
Yes.
Can you point to where?
Here.
Perfect. Okay. 5, 2, 3, 4, 5. And can you just show me the next joint angle? Great. And then the next one?
Here.
Perfect. Okay. So I want you to repeat that every other day. Again, using 50% of your strength, you will do 5 reps, 5 seconds each, 3 sets. 1 set is 1 joint angle, essentially. Okay? Every other vehicle I see next. Any questions?
No.
Okay. The last thing that we're going to be doing is an isotonic strengthening exercise to the right gastrocnemius. So an isotonic exercise is also a muscle contraction, but now there will be some movement at the joint. We'll be taking the muscle through its full range of motion. So the gastroc is part of the tricepsary group, runs from here to here, and the main action is bringing that foot into like a gas pedal position. The reason that we're going to be working on this muscle is because you have tested weak here, so once again, we do want to increase the strength, so it will help you with your soccer practice on Tuesdays. One risk could be that if you don't follow the parameters, you could overwork the muscle and you could possibly tear it. So you just have to work within the parameters that I work. Okay? Any questions so far?
No.
Okay, if you have pain at any time, just let me know and we'll stop and modify. Okay? So I'm going to demonstrate for you. Right? And this is a strength exercise, so we're going to be focusing on using 80% of our strength, and we're going to be working 3 sets for 10 reps. Okay, and we're going to be taking a 2-minute break in between. Okay. And with the isometric, I didn't mention, but 1-minute rest in between. So that's... Ooh. Which you can do in an OP. You can go back and be like, oh, for the other one, this is what you do. So what I'm going to be doing is taking a TheraBand and just wrapping it around my leg or my foot, and all I'm going to be doing is pushing into the resistance. Okay, so that's what I'm going to be doing for 10 reps.
Okay.
Any questions?
No.
If there's any pain, let me know. We'll start.
All right.
I choose a sock, so I should use a towel. Towel here, so she has to go. Okay, and that's for one. And so what we'll do is just to stabilize that because it's slipping. I'm going to, you can let go for a sec. So just make sure that you're breathing throughout. Are you comfortable?
Yes.
Are you feeling the contraction?
Yes.
Can you come to where, please?
Back here.
Perfect. Okay. 8, 9, 10. And then you'll repeat that 2 more times.
Okay.
So once again, it'll be 80% of your strength, 3 sets for 10 reps, and you'll be taking a break for 2 minutes in between. You'll do this every other day until it's